Hey, Jen Max, we're doing a little bit different of a video today. We're always talking about retiring in Mexico, coming down from the US or Canada, and retiring into the good life here. But this time we're having a little bit of a twist on that. And that is someone who was born in Mexico, moved to the United States, and now coming back to Mexico to return to be with family in the city he was born in and has been gone from for a long time. I do get commenters every once in a while who are kind of snarky, who are like, if all these retirees want to move to Mexico, why do Mexicans want to move to the US? And we'll kind of maybe talk about that a little bit in this video, but really we're going to be talking with Fernando about his life and moving here back to the city of his birth.
Hello, I'm Fernando. I was actually born here in La Paz. And after traveling a little bit through Mexico, we ended up in Puerto Vallarta until I was 16, where at that point, my dad was transferred to the US. And I finished college there, got my master's, and worked on my professional career until recently when I decided that it was time for us to retire. My wife and I, 10 months ago, have made it here, and we are now reborn residents of La Paz. We love it here. It's so beautiful.
Yeah, these guys live just down the beach from us. I was out on their patio and I could actually see our house way down the beach. This is a great story here. You know, really a lot of one of the beautiful things that we talk about a lot is like family in Mexico is so important. And that really is gonna play in a lot to this story here is the importance of their family and how close they are living together now. So let's go back to working in the US, living in Arizona, and kind of thinking about what is next, what's coming up, and kind of planning that out.
Well, yes, in Arizona, I'm gonna tell you, it was a good job. I loved it professionally. We were both in a good place. It was just Arizona was getting a little radical, a little bit of political pressure there. And with my son growing up, he was 12 at the time, and us being there in a position where we could retire, we started thinking very seriously about enjoying the good life here in Baja. And while we looked at different places in the world where we could retire, Baja not only had the family factor, but also the beauty, the safety, and we just love the ocean.
So we are going to talk specifically about Surat and with Surat in another video. If that one's available, you'll find it in one of these corners. That is about moving to Mexico with your family, putting your kids in school and how that whole thing works. So that is going to be an additional video. But let's go back to retirement and moving here to be with family.
That's right. My mom was born here. My dad came here from Aztlan. They got married here and they started their life here in La Paz. Eventually, they ended up in Puerto Vallarta, where from the age of 4 all the way to 16, I went to school, and I enjoyed the good life in Puerto Vallarta as well. And my father's job at the time transferred him to the United States. He was doing okay here and ended up with an opportunity to move the family to the United States, which he jumped on, and we ended up moving to the United States, where I finished my college career and started working there.
So now let's jump forward to the end of his father's career in the United States.
That's right. My father got transferred from Phoenix, Arizona to LA, and 2-3 years before his retirement, decided to build his house and another property not too far from here, which he saw to completion right about the same time he retired. And they decided to move here and start enjoying the view and the weather here. I stayed behind in Arizona to complete my professional career until my wife and I were able to retire and come back to the place that where I was born and the place that has most of my family.
And when Fernando says this is the place that has most of his family, we're talking a very small place, so let's hear about that.
That is correct. My father built this house, and when my wife, Syria, and I decided, okay, let's move to La Paz, he said, why don't you build downstairs, because this house is all on the second level. And we said, okay, let's do that. We don't mind living right on the beach. And because of their thinking and my thinking, they offered, why don't you take over the large house and build a small house for us downstairs. So they are literally downstairs right now.
Yes, I just met his parents downstairs. So a wonderful environment, especially for his son to grow up right here. The view from up here is amazing. We're just down the beach. There's a little bit of a beach road in between us and the beach. So having these houses higher up is a little more common on this side of the beach. But his parents still have a wonderful place to live, and they have a lot of the family right here. But let's talk about the kind of decision to move back, and also kind of, I want to dwell a little bit on that idea of people moving to the United States, but coming back to Mexico to retire, because there are people who, like I was born in the United States, and we came down here for the higher quality of life. And I think really a lot of people do go north to work for, you know, in a professional jobs or not professional jobs. But then there's definitely a desire to come back for the quality of life down here.
That's right. La Paz has been a city that we visited throughout the years, back and forth, visiting family on vacation. And it's always been a place that is just great for us. Not only is it peaceful, crime is low, education, there's great schools, there is great hospitals, and the ocean. It just keeps calling you, the ocean. If you like any kind of water sports, walks on the beach, you can do that and you can feel safe.
So I always forget to ask you guys to subscribe. So I'm throwing that here in the middle. If you're not already subscribed, please click that. It would be really helpful for me to grow this channel. And if you're on a TV, you can use this QR code over here and that'll help you subscribe. Yeah, there's so many people up in the United States who kind of have this image of Mexico as being unsafe. And there are areas of Mexico that are unsafe, but there are areas that are incredibly safe. And La Paz is one of those areas that's really safe, very peaceful. I see a boat out front here. So let's talk with Fernando about hobbies. And actually, I know where one of these big hobbies is going to come from, because this is how we met, was at the Comitán market, where he sells some of his hobby wares.
Yes, we were able to purchase this boat in Arizona, out of all places, right? We're landlocked, but we went boating every once in a while at the lakes there, and it's a great activity. But in my mind, we were always looking ahead and thinking of the Sea of Cortez. Having a boat here, it doesn't matter what size or what kind, you have to have a boat in the Sea of Cortez. Fishing and just throwing the anchor and jumping in the water to take some pictures of the sea life, or just explore with a snorkel and a mask, that is amazing.
Let's hear more about pictures, because the whole house you can see here is pretty much covered in some beautiful photography.
Yes, photography is something that I love. Videography, I love also. I love taking the pictures, having the thought behind it, and being able to capture that one image that is just something that you feel good about. People might love it, people might not love it, but as long as you feel good with it, same thing with video, editing the video and telling a story. I'm sure you know about that, Brian. You're able to convey a message, and that is very rewarding to me as well.
Okay, so now let's get into the hobby, which is the one where we crossed paths.
Because of the nature of my work that I retired from in Arizona, when COVID started, about 4 or 5 months after that, I was asked to work from home. And I did not have the time to commute anymore, which normally it took about 2 hours out of my day. So I had extra time at the end of my day and at the beginning of my day to explore new hobbies. And one of them became woodworking. And I started doing a little bit of carving and ended up settling with turning bowls, turning flower vases, and charcuterie boards, and all kinds of things, including cutting boards as well. And I was surprised that the things that I was making, other people liked, and I started to actually really enjoy the hobby. My neighbors got to enjoy it also, because they were getting all kinds of gifts constantly from stuff that I was experimenting with. So they would swing by and say, what else do you have for me?
So we're gonna do a quick house tour in a bit, which is gonna include a tour of that workshop. And Fernando's work is just gorgeous. We saw it out, like I mentioned, out at the Comitán market. That's a once a month thing, and that's where he sells his stuff now. So what I was really surprised by is that this is a recent hobby. This is a 5-year-old hobby or something like that. And And he's really, really good at it. And his workshop, I'm definitely jealous. It reminds me of the workshop that my father had when I was growing up. Even some of the tools, like the Delta bandsaw, things like that, same tools that he had. But let's dig in here a little bit. Maybe we're gonna talk a little bit about his son, just a tiny bit, because the other video is gonna talk more about that, and then we're gonna walk around the house.
Yes, our son Serhat was in sixth grade in Arizona, up till sixth grade, and he landed here in seventh grade. And what we were trying to do is, it's very stressful for us as parents, as you can imagine, to grab your kid and not only move him from one school to the next, but also moving from one country to the next. Unfortunately for all of us, Serhat's Spanish was very lacking. So let's just say that it was non-existent. So his language barrier is huge, or was going to be huge when we were making this decision. It was something that we also contemplated, which prompted us to do a little bit heavier research on bilingual schools. And La Paz offers, thankfully, several options, which I would recommend that everybody visits them in person and tours a school, which is something that we did. It took us a little bit of time, but we took the time to do it. And we finally decided on a school that works for him. And he is very sad to leave his friends and continues to miss them. However, he has made a lot of new friends here. And they all know La Paz, they live here, and they are from here, most of them. And they are very helpful. They have brought him into the family that they have there, into the fabric of the school. And they help him with translations, they help him with English. Most of the kids speak perfect English. Most of the teachers speak English. And it has been a rather painless assimilation for him from during the transition. Keeping in mind that he does miss his old friends.
Actually, I'm filming this right before we leave for the season, and this just kind of like put a little ping into my head about how I'm sad to be leaving behind all my friends here in Mexico, because I feel like, I don't know, I've got a more close-knit social network down here of adult friends than I do up in Portland, and so I can totally get where Serhat was coming from with leaving his friends behind. But let's switch gears back to the house now, and we're gonna go through the house, and we're gonna exit through the gift shop, I guess. if you sold your stuff online, it would truly be a gift shop. We're gonna exit through the workshop.
The house is so open, we love it. It's got good lighting, which is very important for my wife, Syria. The kitchen is just the open design with a large island, and we're sitting right now in the dining room area. We have a little bit of a living room on this side, family room on that side. Right behind me, we have this hall, and that's from where the three bedrooms split from. And, you know, it's got the standard three-bedroom, three-bath type of house with all the amenities. Finally, we have the office where I do my photo and video editing. It's a little station there with all my electronic gadgets.
Okay, so now take us outside to the outdoor living space.
Outside, we have a really, this is one of the things that gets me really excited. The balcony, and I don't know what else to call it, it's like twice as wide as the balconies that I'm used to. So it allows you to really stretch out in the balcony, but then it flows into a nice little terrace area where we're able to enjoy the view, listen to the ocean. The waves are tiny, but you can still hear them. The mangroves are right there. Every evening, the birds make a ruckus, and it's just beautiful to listen. And then we have a little pool area where we get to enjoy taking a dip in the pool whenever it's really hot out here.
Yes, and a reminder that we are up on the second floor, so pretty cool that they've got an in-the-ground pool on the second floor. But let's go ahead and work our way downstairs and check out the workshop.
Downstairs, I have my shop. The shop was recently enclosed because it originally was all open, just nothing but pillars and necessary walls to keep the second level house where it is. But since we built the house with my parents down there, and it created the opportunity to create a proper shop for us, where it actually is enclosed and it gives us a little bit more security, leaving tools out and all that stuff. When my father retired and he was living here and I was living in Arizona, we would speak all the time on the phone. And when he found out that I was starting to work with wood and start to purchase some of the wood tools that I have, he said, I want to do that too. So he started working and purchasing and learning on his own as I was doing the same thing. And the funny thing is that when I retired and I came here, not only did I bring myself, my family, and my furniture, but I also brought my tools, which you'll see that there's doubles and sometimes triples of certain tools that he had purchased and that I have purchased. And when I brought them here with me, now we have two or three of each.
Yeah, so my father passed 5, 6, 7 years ago now. And I think, you know, the idea of being able to work together, because when I was building a house in Atlanta, renovating a house in Atlanta, he came down and helped me with that. And so Fernando is your father too, right? They're right here and can do this kind of stuff together. I think that's just such an ideal situation in retirement. And it's something, it's important to have those hobbies, have things to do to keep you busy. And, but it's nice to just kind of slow down and slide into an enjoyable retirement.
Living with your parents in such close proximity can raise your eyebrow, if you know what I mean. However, I'm gonna tell you that we love it. They are so close to us. We share meals together. Sometimes we just say, let's go. We go to the malecon, we go to the beach together, we go fishing. And we don't have to go and physically visit each other. We are right here. And yet there's enough of a separation to keep each other's privacy at the same time. But being able to enjoy one of my hobbies with my own father, it's amazing. It is truly rewarding and more than emotionally as well. Psychologically, you feel like you're sharing moments with your father that, you know, perhaps in previous years you didn't get to because of distances or different schedules.
Yeah, I'm seeing more of this kind of multi-generational thing. I mean, that's multi-generation living is the way things work in Mexico. But I'm seeing more of that with people coming down. I've got a video about bringing mom to Mexico. I've got a video also about people bringing their families from their older parents to places like Ajijic, where they can live in an assisted living facility or something like that. So there's a lot of opportunities. And I guess the point here is don't let anything become a barrier. Break down those barriers and get to living your dream life. And if you've got kids, you're going to want to watch this video. If it's ready, it's up here about bringing your kids to Mexico. Otherwise, on the opposite side of the spectrum is bringing mom to Mexico. So we'll see you in one of those videos. Hasta luego.